morning coasters. Here we are in Kumara. Beautiful day, February 22nd, is it? And we are about to do part of the West Coast Wilderness Trail on our bikes. So today we're aiming to do from Kumara through Cowboys Paradise right through to Hokitika. So it's a distance of about 72 kilometres. Now, I should take the time to tell you I am not fit. I am not a cyclist. So for those of you who think you can't do it, and that it's for experienced, you know, very fit people, I am sacrificing myself as your guinea pig, and I will let you know along the way how we go.
I drank champagne with kings and queens. The politicians praised my name. But those are someone else's dreams. The pitfalls of the man I be.
Sit rep, we're about 10k in. My voice sounds a bit funny because my ear's blocked. But that's quite normal. We've been around the Kawaka Dam. And now we're going through some native bush, and it is just absolutely mind-blowingly gorgeous. So, yeah, we break and we carry on.
Kylie?
Good. Doing well.
Awesome. It's beautiful in here, guys. Look at this. Right, eh? We'll keep on moseying on.
Yeah.
we're halfway for today. So we've gone 36 kilometers from Kumara to this quirky little place called Cowboys Paradise. So we're up here in the middle of the mountains, and the views everywhere are spectacular. And there's this crazy little place that you can stay at. They do buffet meals in the evenings, and they have a bit of entertainment that's them practicing in there at the moment. And the owner, Mike, met him, bit of a character, which you would expect on the West Coast. So look, all going well, I'm not gonna lie, I'm feeling it. Butt's getting sore, legs are getting sore, battery's getting low. But we shall carry on and try and get to Hokitika today. Couple of things, sunscreen, make sure you have it. Bug spray, make sure you wear it. Toilets, I was worried about the lack of toilets along the way. But they have got them scattered in quite a few places. Like you're not short of a toilet. So, so far, super impressed. Just can't beat the scenery. And the people we've met along the way have been just beautiful people. So ready to start the next leg. Wish me luck. Spectacular day. As you can see, I am showered and clean. I have never been as dusty as I got today. I literally ate dust, but that's okay. What a wonderful day. So we went 72 kilometers and it took us about 6 hours, and we have ended up here in Hokitika. What I'd like to say to you is, if you're considering doing this trip, don't just consider it, don't just think about it, don't put it off till tomorrow. Do it. There's four sections: Greymouth to Kumara, Kumara to Cowboy Paradise, Cowboy Paradise to Hokitika, and Hokitika to Ross. They're about 30 kilometers roughly on each sector. What I would say is that if you are unfit, like me, put into your budget to hire an e-bike. Makes all the difference. Gets you up those hills, gives you a bit of push. You still have to work, but it really, really does help. Now, there's a lot of companies in Hokitika who can help organise that for you. They can also organise transport to the start and the finish of different sectors, if you're wanting to do just one bit. Or you can go full hog and go and get a full tour. So that includes accommodation along the way, they take your bags to each stop along the way, meals, all sorts of things can be included. So do your research and make sure you pick the trip that is right for you and your group. Absolutely marvellous. The scenery was unbelievable. Unfortunately, I ran out of battery because I'd taken so many pictures. So I couldn't take any video of the Lake Canary to Hokitika sector, which was, in my opinion, the most beautiful part of the trip. Going through rainforest, along the ancient waterway, oh, just do it. Just book some leave-in. Come visit the West Coast and experience this world-class attraction. You won't regret it.